watching CCTV International. On July 7th, 2000, Guangxi's Nanguo Morning Daily carried an article entitled, "I Want to Go Home." The homesick individual was the elderly Mrs. Sung Zhongfang. Now 87 years old, Mrs. Sung has spent the last 63 years in Hejila Village, Xing'an County, Guangxi Zhuang Autonomous Region. Mrs. Sung had always been silent about her past, so her fellow residents knew little about what brought her to their village. Mo Shouqiang, a reporter for the Nanguo Morning. On December 13, 1937, the Japanese army invaded Nanjing and began a bloody massacre of the local civilians. Within 40 days, more than 300,000 people were killed, 20,000 women raped. Sun Zhongfang hid in the Qinhuai River behind her house for 2 whole days. When it got dark on the second day, she came out and saw something that would haunt her forever. Her sister-in-law had been raped and killed, and 2 of her sons had also been slaughtered. Sun's mother, husband, and remaining son were nowhere to be found. She joined the increasing crowd of refugees fleeing Nanjing every day. She passed through Anhui Province and Hubei Province before finally settling in Hejila Village in Guangxi. For 63 years, Sun has remained there, where she attempted to live a more peaceful life.
Mm-hmm. 这个小狗子是第二胎，为什么他父亲就是弟兄一个人少，我生下来的时候呢，年轻也不懂那些道理，在屁股上在拍他的时候，叫他喊那个狗，就叫个小狗带来，然后跑这个，他讲这个就是你小狗子，你晓不得，哦，讲是我小狗子，晓不得他，我才晓得。
For a young woman who had been born and raised in one of the country's largest cities, the adjustment to a rural life was not easy. She first married a former Kuomintang soldier who died soon after. She married a second and a third time, and neither of these marriages brought her any children. During all those years, Sun had written letter after letter after letter to Nanjing. All were returned.She imagined that her home had been destroyed and that maybe all of her family members were dead. Near Hajila village, there is a small railway station. Sun would often pass by the station, stopping to think of her hometown that was only a train ride away.
设法要跟南京方面的媒体找一家比较有影响、当地有影响的媒体联络。那这样的双方就两地啊，在这里呢这样的合作，给他回去就是最起码的一个愿望，给他回故乡去圆他这个回乡梦。当然就属于在他那个什么逃的过程中呢，跟他的那个亲人失散了。如果是通过这个活动，他能够找到他的亲人、儿子啊，或者是他的那个什么其他的亲人的话，那么这个结局将是最圆满的。
Nanjing's Yangtze Evening Daily received the message from Nanguo Morning Daily and carried the same article, I want to go home. The article aroused the enthusiastic response of the citizens of Nanjing. At the same time, some journalists began to look for Sun Zhongfang's son.
这个草是摆过去，这村子这么稳。
在你这个安排这些工作的时候，同样的就要问一下，还有哪些人对孙中，因为孙中芳走的时候24岁了，顺便留神一下，还有哪些熟悉他的或者熟悉他家的，这样的话，他还有一个妹妹没有找到，还有一个13的儿子。如果在这个过程当中，我们能提供一些重要线索的话，我们也得到很大的安慰。对老人来说的话，当然是更开心的一个事儿了，好不好？
不给他遗憾，
哎，争取不给他遗憾。对对对。
With the help of the Nanguo Morning Daily and the Yangtze Evening Daily, Sun Zhongfang arrived in Wuxi and then changed buses to reach Nanjing on July 18th. She finally stepped on the soil of her hometown after 63 years. The news of Sun's return home quickly spread over the city. Local residents, especially from the street where she had lived before, flocked to greet her.The household committee on the street where she lived gave her a warm reception.
往南京住的狗的啊，你姓王的。
我到你原来的家乡了，你到你原来的地方了，啦。他们的新年还高兴啊？
还不高兴。
啊，高兴高兴啊！
怎么高兴呢？能不能跟我们讲讲？
怎么高兴啊？怎么高兴？
回在自己家里了。
在广西，
这个就
是会不会经常做梦都会想到家以前的样子呢？你还会想到家，在睡觉的时候想不想到家以前的样子啊？记得。
晚上睡觉都没得气。
他闷到闷到他。
闷到的哦。
做梦做梦。
Song Zhongfang's home was located in Pingsu Street. Everything has changed except the name of the street. Tall buildings have replaced the old, shabby houses.
We today have another person, one called Zhu.
Zhu Xuewen.
Called Zhu Xuewen. This person gave us a very good clue. But this person, but he doesn't have any precise address. So,
75.
那个是到70最多了，要不了到75，缩小范围。
八八分的也不像了。
看看红五路的有没有？
太平南路，哎，红五路的。
啊。
是不是红五路？
哎，299号 ，A 点不错。
是不是啊？
哎，一点不错。四单元408。
408是有红龙宫。
就第一次我来，有点像啊、哦。
哎，像。
有点像，有点像。
好、啊，再见，再见啊。
谢谢。
哎，好。
On July 21st, Sun Zhongfang visited the museum of the Nanjing Massacre. She persistently believed that here rested the souls of her loved ones killed by the Japanese. Zhu Chengsheng, director of the museum, introduced her to some survivors of the Nanjing Massacre.
I'll introduce you.这是我们南京的幸存者李秀英老妈妈，哎，李秀英，哎，
你好，
哎，这个是夏淑琴老妈妈，哎，嗯，这是李翠萍，他们，嗯，这个李秀英啊。当时是这个身上被戳了30多刀，在这个美国人的医院呢，被美国的这个医生救护下来。夏淑琴家呢在中华门边上呢，一家呢有9口人，南京中华门啊，有9口人被杀。你妈妈一家呢也是这个身上啊，还有子弹，有的弹孔。哎，
我看是，
嗯。
要不你就
嗯，
对
了。嗯。
呀。
嗯。子弹从这儿打进，
爸爸妈妈一起打死的。
哎，他自己死了很多人，有10000多人在这儿遇难，所以我们这是一个万人坑啊，这个所在地。我们这儿也挖出来许多的这个遇难者的遗骨，一共有7层，一层。
In front of the painting, the Nanjing Massacre, Sun thinks of her son again.
哦，就是个小狗子，还没得这个大。
小狗子。
你还没有他那么大，是吧？
那个
小狗子没这么。
小狗子
比这个还小一点。
比这还小一点。好的。来来来，我是杨子妈妈生气的。啊，坐。那您坐，
好，跟上海取得了一些联系，但是现在呢，这个由于那个第八纺织机械厂啊，
撤掉了，
他早就撤掉了，
啊，
这个人员变化也挺多，几易其主了，
啊，
所以说呢，现在这个我们一边在那儿查，第二个今天这么热的天来打扰你一下，还想有可能的情况下，我们再了解点稍微细一点的情况，
他50年来跟你说，来的时候碰了一次面，
嗯，
哎，他来
的，59年前后吧，
他早，哎，
这个叫小狗子了，但是他来的时候已经叫陈家才，
哦，孙家才，
已经叫孙家才了，
已经。开始的时候已经叫孙家才了，
哦，
就是我跟他，就是我妈妈调我到那去了，他已经改成姓孙了。
下面单元我们能找到，如果一旦找不到的话，这个线索真实就。
你把那个稿子再拿过去，再跟
改跟母姓，改跟母亲是吧？跟母亲姓叫孙家才，
嗯，
好了，联系就联系。
对对。
The reporters of the Yangtze Evening Daily discovered the whereabouts of Song Zhongfang's son, Little Puppy. He escaped with his grandmother to Shanghai after the Japanese rape of Nanjing. Now he is a 68-year-old retiree in Shanghai.
问起来了，因为还有我母亲在哪里了，还是在外地，还是怎么样，还是死了？你总得给我说个所以然，是吧？他说嘛，主要是这个日本人打仗，失散了，估计呢是死了。后来他感觉人年纪大了。不行了，那就经常讲，就是我，你母亲是很好的一个人，就是人长得比较高大，是吧？比较清秀，是吧？经常看看这个照片，那就可以跟他讲的这母亲，介绍我母亲的这形象，你就可能把他认出来。
On July 22nd, Sun Jiazai went with his wife and son to Nanjing to meet Song Zhongfang. From what the journalist told him about the old lady, he was sure Song Zhongfang was his mother. The staff handed him all the papers carrying follow-up news about Song Zhongfang. After reading about her tragedies, Sun Jiazai was full of emotion.
这照片你还
认识，
还能认识吧？
哪个是你啊？奶奶，看看哪个是你啊？
哪个是你？看不见。
好久没看到了。
哎，这个呢？
这个你认得吧？
这个。
这个你认得？
这个是外婆吧？这个是
妈妈。这个你认得吧？
这个是我的妈妈的吧？
是妈妈。
养大，还靠这个手，身体。好了，以后就好了，好吧？你孙子很好的，是吧？很好，他有能耐，他有本事，是吧？没有问题啊。
老天。
Having found her son.Song Zhongfang takes out the melon seeds of happiness she has brought from Guangxi.
就要
中午回去，跟我回上海去。
就去了？
现在不去。现在你不是到这里来参观了？还要跟这个集体回去，还跟他们回去。回去以后呢？
通信
一次，我再把你接回来，接到上海。好吧。
你把那那里的事情
聊一聊，
整
理整理，安排。
晓得。
是吧？然后呢，我到带着你的这个孙男孙女的，到广西，把你在那里接回来。这样，这你找到我了吗？就什么事都解决了，是吧？找到我什么事都解决了。你走了以后嘛，我们马上就回到上海，挨些安排一下，是吧？带你安排一个房间，是吧？跟我们住在一起，南京。我也。
几十年的事情，现在就是靠大家请到这个在，哪有这个好事？你感谢不了他们，帮睡觉，把梦都没有办成，这个没想起这样的情感。
你回家好好，好好照顾他。我过个几天来接你，我过十几天来接你。
你到上海等你去啊！不去了，我要走了。
Back in Shanghai, Sun Jiazai and his wife were busy cleaning up a room for their mother. At the same time, they were making preparations to go to Guangxi to bring her back home. In Hejila village, Sun Zhongfang shared the good news of finding her son with her neighbors.
个见到我的母亲以后啊，我一直睡不好觉，很想呢早点把母亲接回去。这个愿望呢今天实现了。由于63年前日本帝国主义侵略我们中国，屠杀我们这个南京人民，我母亲为了避这个战火逃到了这里，有这里的这个父老乡亲啊热情帮助，是吧，使他呢能够健康的活到现在。我母亲呢这个离开我63年了，这一次我把她接回家以后，让母亲呢离开第二故土，这里是她的第二故乡了。把我母亲接回去以后呢，今后我们就不分开了，寸步不离。和我的母亲啊就寸步不离啊，这个让她这个颐享天年。
All the villagers came and brought out the best they had to hold a farewell party. They were living like one big family with Song Zhongfang. It was hard for them to break away from Grandma Song. Song Zhongfang was reunited with her family in Shanghai on August 9th. From Nanjing to Guangxi, from Guangxi to Shanghai, Song Zhongfang, treading over a road of life and death, separation and reunion, has turned from a young woman into a white-haired old lady. But she missed Nanjing the most, because Nanjing is her home.